to you. How about 8:53 now? 8 before the top of the hour. Red Sox, well, we got a whole Red Sox debriefing there in the last break, didn't we? So it's Beckett on the mound tonight, right?
We are. It was fantastic.
All right, good. Good. Well, introduce our fine friend. Look at us.
Well, we're glad to have her. She'll also be joining us next Tuesday at 7 a.m. with the Commissioner of Economic and Community Development.
Yay!
Greg, and pronounce Greg's last name. I never can.
George Gervais.
I'm George. Why do I call him Greg?
Pull that big guy. Well, you pull it right
there. You know, he actually was on the phone with us, and I called him Greg 3 times. Why do I keep doing that?
Mr. Commissioner would be fine.
Mr. Commissioner is the best way to do it. Exactly. Well, I didn't call him Greg on the air. So, anyhow, State Representative Amy Volk is joining us. She's a state rep from part of Scarborough. You're on the ocean side, right?
Yes. Yep.
Peter Truman, if you're listening, I need you to meet her. Peter owns the Lighthouse Inn right at Pine Point, and he would love you.
Would love to meet him.
Hey, awesome. That's great. Thanks for coming in here today. One thing we're going to get into, and I know, or Ray will with you next week, and the commissioner too, jobs are starting to pop up around Maine. We have the Millinocket Mills that have been bought, which is terrific, and I know you two will talk about it. Call center with Lewiston, going to add 250 jobs.
Mm-hmm.
Already, we've added up the amount of jobs already under this administration, LePage administration, compared to one of Baldacci's, and it's already 3-1.
Just getting this right. A lot of positive things happening around the state.
Now, what did you hear? Let's go to some immediate news. Yesterday, the redistricting commission met. There are 15 members of the council, 7 Democrats, 7 Republicans, 1 quote-unquote independent.
Right.
There were 7 Republicans voted for the Republican plan, 7 Democrats voted for the Democrat plan, and the independents sided with the Democrat.
Mm-hmm.
What are you hearing from your colleagues?
Well, I don't think the vote took anyone by surprise except perhaps the independent. You know, nobody knew quite which way he was going to swing.
And which way did he?
He went with the Democrats. And so what we're doing is we're, you know, hoping to still get to some sort of a consensus plan. We haven't lost hope for that. We're back to our, eastern, western Maine map, the original map, but we are definitely working toward a consensus.
How does a court decide? Because eventually the state Supreme Court will have to decide. How will they decide, and what will you ask them to base it on, do we think?
I don't think it's going to get to that point, Ted.
Oh, good. Oh,
no,
okay.
I really don't. I mean, we've been able to get to a 2/3 majority on a lot of other issues, and I think we'll be able to get to 2/3 on this one. We're willing to work. We've already offered a lot of compromises, and, you know, it's our feeling that the Democrats don't have the votes to pass a 2/3 with their plan. So, you know, we're gonna arrive at something. I don't think we're going to send it to the courts.
And that's right, they don't. I mean, Ken Verdet, state rep from Newport, came out to say yesterday, Republican House, Republican Senate, clearly we're not going to have a 2/3 vote for the Democrat plan. We won the election. Elections have consequences.
Is it also true we're redistricting to the point where Kucinich is thinking about running for Maine?
No, he's still going out to Oregon.
Oregon. Kucinich, everybody. I do notice California is going through a lot of redistricting, too. But, boy, a lot of new names get to pop up, and of a sudden it opens it up, arguably, to other folks who may or may not have run, you know, in the past.
Yeah, so it's not unique to Maine. And this isn't something that we've decided to do. I mean, it's been court ordered that this is something that we do have to work out, and we'll work it out.
You know, we also saw a national article this morning, and it's good to see the national news cover bath salts. And there's a handful of states now that have it illegal to possess, let alone transport or otherwise buy, these bath salts. And I know we've talked about it so very often, except to say that one of the things outside of redistricting you're going to be dealing with at the end of September when you folks come back for that minute and a half, right? Is going to be bath salts and upping the criminality of all of that.
Mm-hmm.
And I suspect that, I think it's an easy vote. I suspect it would be something that you folks would want to deal with immediately. As this governor does.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, what they put forward for legislation, but I'm sure that we will strengthen the law that we've already enacted.
I would think so. Oh, geez, I hope so.
Yeah, I think I came late to this party. I mean, I thought it was, as I think Beth O'Connor, the state rep from Berwick, said the other day, this is not your grandmother's Calgon, which is what I thought it was. I thought, you know, because I've read where kids will take Comet and do something, you know, the cleanser and do something with it. So I thought, once again, they had found, you know, sniffing glue, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
This is a whole different ball game.
Because of what it does to the violent tendencies and all of that.
Well, we heard a report this morning where someone did very little of it, but it made them feel they could fly, and they jumped off a balcony and fell to death. So.
Well, and the scary thing about it is the way that the it can be genetic, chemically engineered, so that because they've developed a test for it, they can just change it slightly, and metabolically, it's undetectable again. That's the real scary piece about it.
What else is scary? If they're smart enough to mix chemicals, why can't they get a job?
That's true.
I mean, as a chemist, everybody, right? Insurance.
Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly right. It's funny you brought that up, because we talked about this yesterday with Heather Sorocki and Beth O'Connor, the two state reps, that they are, you can pass the law for what it is today, but they're able to change it, the substance, and then suddenly the substance they've come up with is now illegal.
Right.
That's one of the grand problems with this, apparently.
Yeah. You almost, it'd be interesting to see what they put forward for legislation.
Yeah, because I think many legislators across the board, I know Ray hates the word bipartisan, but if ever there was a bipartisan effort on this new things, getting in front of it, we talk about technology.
Right.
Or legislation having to catch up with technology all the time, right? If it's bullying, if it's the Facebook and policies, legislation has to do the same, and is doing so. So we look forward to that. Thanks for coming in here.
My pleasure.
I hope to see you soon.
Enjoy your donuts.
Don't you think I won't?
We'll see you Tuesday morning. State Representative Amy Volk, thanks for being here.
Thank you, Amy. 9 a.m. now.